Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Earlier this morning, SpaceX launched the Starlink 5-4 mission on a Falcon 9 rocket.
2-1, engines full power, and liftoff of Starlink 5-4.
The booster which launched this mission, B1062, then landed successfully for the 12th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitas.
Stage 1 landing burn.
Stage 1 has now lit one engine to prepare for landing on our drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitas. This final burn slows down the rocket and will help it land on the drone ship.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Falcon 9 has successfully landed on our drone ship, A Shortfall of Gravitas, making this our 160th landing of a Falcon 9 first stage.
We can hopefully expect another launch this coming week. The Starlink 2-5 mission is currently scheduled to lift off on Wednesday 15th at 4:32 PM UTC or 11:32 AM EST. I wanted to share an article with information from Gwynne Shotwell, as there's something specific I wanted to point out related to Starlink. It says this year Starlink will make money. We actually had a cash flow positive quarter last year, Shotwell said. Michael Baylor posted this tweet earlier this morning with a picture of Ship 26 rolling out. He said Ship 26 is rolling out at Starbase. This vehicle has no flaps, payload bay or heat shield. It was rolled out to the Pad A test mount. On Thursday, SpaceX posted this super cool picture of the Booster 7 engine bay. They said 33 Raptor engine static fire attempt soon. Then on Thursday, SpaceX attempted to light all 33 Raptor engines for a fully fledged static fire test. After the successful static fire, SpaceX posted a tweet saying full duration. After the static fire, Musk also posted a tweet and provided more information on the test. He said, team turned off one engine just before start and one stopped itself, so 31 engines fired overall, but still enough engines to reach orbit. SpaceX livestreamed the static fire, which is not something they'd usually do. I wanted to share that video. SpaceX also posted a cool aerial view from a drone of the Booster 7 static fire test. I also wanted to share this super awesome photo from above of the Booster 7 static fire. SpaceX also posted some more cool pictures of the Booster 7 static fire and provided information on the outcome of the test. They said Super Heavy Booster 7 completed a full duration static fire test of 31 Raptor engines producing 7.9 million pound feet of thrust, approximately 3600 metric tons, less than half of the booster's capability. There was another tweet posted by Musk related to this test. He said this test is at approximately 50% throttle. Launch attempt next month will be at approximately 90%. Taking a look at the upcoming road and beach closures, SpaceX have some dates for this coming week. There are possible closures currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 13th, Tuesday 14th and Wednesday 15th. As always, I have to say thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.